To understand what Kubernetes is, you first need to know what a container is. A container is a lightweight, isolated environment for running applications, bundling everything needed, including the code, runtime, libraries, and system tools. Containers virtualize only the runtime environment, such as CPU, memory, or file system, and not the entire machine, unlike a virtual machine or VM. It results in containers being lighter than VMs, allowing for the creation of many more containers on a single server, with less storage, memory, and CPU wasted. Think of a container as a set of processes on the operating system. Docker is a popular containerization platform. Since a container is closely tied to the OS, it doesn't know what's happening outside of its host machine. This is where Kubernetes comes in. Kubernetes is an open-source container orchestration system. Kubernetes provides orchestration and management for containers across server clusters. In other words, Kubernetes deploys, scales, and manages containerized applications across various hosts, whether physical server or virtual machines. These clusters can span hosts located in public, private, or hybrid clouds. With Kubernetes, developers no longer need to manage virtual machines. Kubernetes abstracts away the underlying infrastructure, enabling developers to focus on their applications without worrying about where or how they are running. They have direct access to their execution environment, the container, to deploy their code, and Kubernetes takes care of the underlying infrastructure layers. Let's explore the benefits of Kubernetes. Scalability. Kubernetes handles horizontal scalability by adding or removing containers. It's very easy to adjust the number of containers based on demand, almost instantly. Self-healing. Kubernetes automatically restarts failing containers. Efficiency. Containers use fewer resources than VMs. Portability. Kubernetes runs applications consistently across different environments. A containerized application can run on any infrastructure, including on-premises data centers and multiple cloud providers. Let's look at the major components of Kubernetes architecture. Kubernetes uses a control plane node model. The control plane, or master node, manages the entire Kubernetes cluster and its resources, including scheduling workloads, maintaining desired states, and handling failovers. The worker nodes are the machines that run containerized applications, executing assigned tasks. The control plane consists of the following components. The API server allows communication with worker nodes and components of the control plane. The API server is the entry point for all the commands used to control the cluster. We can interact with these APIs using a command line tool called kubectl. The controller manager executes cluster-level functions such as replication, monitors worker nodes, and manages node-level errors. When you deploy an application, the scheduler assigns a node to that application. Etcd is a distributed data store that stores the cluster's configuration. It is a central database for storing the current cluster state at any point in time. And the worker node relies on these components. The kubelet communicates with the API server and manages containers at the node level. It ensures that the defined containers have started and are running as intended. For example, if a node fails, it reports it to the Kubernetes control plane. Kubeproxy acts as a network proxy and load balancer for services on a single worker node and manages network routing. Now let's take a closer look at the concept of a pod. Within a node, a pod runs. A pod is the runtime environment for one or more containers. A pod can contain one or more containers that share resources like storage and network. All containers in a pod share the same IP address, host name, network ports, and other resources such as storage. Horizontal scalability is achieved by instantiating the application in multiple pods. It verifies the requested number of identical pod copies that should run in the cluster. The master determines which node will run an unscheduled pod based on resource availability. The master manages resource utilization on each node to ensure that the workload doesn't exceed available resources. Kubernetes ensures pod resilience using replica sets, which are managed by the control plane, specifically the controller manager. If a pod fails, the replica set will detect the absence of a pod and create a new pod to replace it. Here, node 1 encounters an error, and the pods 1 and 2 disappear. The replica set detects this change and creates new pods on another node, in this case, node 2. Finally, a service is an entry point that provides load-balanced access to a set of pods via an IP address or domain name. Services are often used to represent different application tiers, such as a front-end web server or a back-end database service. An Ingress is an API object that manages incoming HTTP and HTTPS traffic to services within a Kubernetes cluster. It defines rules such as path-based or host-based routing to control how requests are directed. Thanks for tuning in. If you found this video useful, hit that subscribe button to stay updated with my future videos. And if you think someone else might find it helpful, share it with them. See you next time. Bye.